A very good morning to my wonderful Vidyashriyans of grade 6. Welcome to your social science class with your teacher Jyoti Arya. Well children, today in our class we are going to read chapter number 5 from your civics book, that is Panchayati Raj. So let's see in this chapter how the government works at local level. So without wasting the time, let's start with the chapter.
पंचायती राज. पंचायती राज इज अ सिस्टम ऑफ सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट एट द विलेज लेवल. इंडिया इज अ ह्यूज कंट्री एंड इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर द सेंट्रल और द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट टू एड्रेस द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ द पीपल लिविंग इन एवरी कॉर्नर ऑफ इट. थ्रू द पंचायती राज सिस्टम लोकल पीपल पार्टिसिपेट इन द गवर्नेंस ऑफ देयर ओन एरियाज, आइडेंटिफाई एंड सॉल्व देयर ओन प्रॉब्लम्स. स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ पंचायती राज. द पंचायती राज इज अ थ्री टायर सिस्टम. इट वर्क्स एट थ्री लेवल्स. द ग्राम पंचायत एट द विलेज लेवल और द ब्लॉक समिति और द पंचायत समिति एट द ब्लॉक लेवल एंड द जिला परिषद एट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल. द ग्राम पंचायत. द ग्राम सभा, द ग्राम पंचायत एंड द न्याया पंचायत आर द पार्ट्स ऑफ द पंचायत एट द विलेज लेवल. द ग्राम सभा कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ मेन एंड वीमेन इन अ विलेज हु आर 18 ईयर्स ऑफ एज एंड अबव. They meet at least twice a year and elect the Gram Panchayat. The Gram Sabha evaluates the work and accounts of income and expenditure of the Gram Panchayat. It acts as a check on the powers of Gram Panchayat and has the power to remove any of its members if his or her work is unsatisfactory. Gram Panchayat members are elected for a period of 5 years. Seats are reserved for members of the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes in proportion to their population in that area. 50% of the total number of seats are reserved for women. The leader of the Gram Panchayat is known as the Sarpanch or Pradhan. He is elected by the Gram Sabha members. A deputy leader or Up Pradhan is also elected. 1/3 of the total number of the offices of the Sarpanch are reserved for women. Let's see functions of the Gram Panchayat. What they do? The Gram Panchayat has the following functions. Like they provide basic amenities such as clean drinking water and sanitation to the villages. Number 2, they maintain wells, tanks and pumps. They collect taxes and fees from the villages. Maintaining health care centers and providing basic health care facilities are also a part of the Gram Panchayat. Constructing and maintaining roads, street lights, maintaining records of birth and death in the villages, providing educational facilities, constructing and maintaining school buildings, and looking after buying and selling of village properties, these all are the functions of the Gram Panchayat. Let's see from where they get the income to build these many things. From where they are getting that income? Let's read about their sources of income. The Gram Panchayat needs money to perform its various functions. The sources of income of the Gram Panchayat are grants from the state government, taxes imposed on houses, shops and farms in the villages, and income from sale of cattle and property. The Gram Sabha and the Gram Panchayat have a common Panchayat secretary who is a government employee. He maintains the records of the work done by both the organizations. Let's see what is Nyaya Panchayat. There is one Nyaya Panchayat for 3 to 4 villages. It is like a mini court. The members are elected by the Gram Panchayats. The Nyaya Panchayat resolves minor disputes of the villages, such as petty thefts and trespassing, and also provides speedy justice. It cannot send a person to prison, but can only impose fines. If a person is not satisfied with the judgment of the Nyaya Panchayat, he can appeal to a higher court. Let's know about Block Samiti. In states with a population of more than 20 lakhs, there is a Block Samiti for a block of 20 to 60 villages. It is the link between the Gram Panchayat and the district administration. Members of the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha and the Legislative Council and the Legislative Assembly from the block become the members of the Block Samiti. Seats are reserved for women and for members of the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. Other members of the Block Samiti are elected by the people of the block. The members of the Block Samiti elect a chairperson or pramukh as well as a vice person or the uppramukh. Let's read about Zila Parishad. The topmost level of the Panchayati Raj at the district level is the Zila Parishad. It acts as a link between the local and state government. The Zila Parishad is also an elected body. Its members are elected from the district on the basis of adult franchisee for a term of 5 years. Members of the state legislature and members of parliament from the district are also members of Zila Parishad. Functions of the Zila Parishad. The Zila Parishad advises the helps and the government of Gram Panchayat and Block Samiti and informs the state government about the work being done by them. It looks after the development of cottage, small-scale industries and opening of cooperative societies in the district. It imparts new techniques of training to farmers and maintains pastures and grazing lands. It maintains primary health centers and hospitals in the villages and conducts vaccination programs against epidemics and family welfare campaigns. The Zila Parishad also sets up school in the village and conducts adult literacy programs. It supervises the implementation of projects under the 5-year plans in the district. Let's know about importance of Panchayati Raj. In a democracy, people from every section of the society should get a chance to participate in the governance of the country. Panchayati Raj has brought democracy to grassroots levels, that is to the villages. It has created a journal and political awareness, especially in the fields of education, health and environment. Women and the backward sections of the society have also got a platform to voice their opinions and grievances. Women in Panchayats. Women are playing an increasingly important role in the Panchayati Raj structure. The increasing number of women sarpanch throughout the country shows the political empowerment of women at the village level. Some people say that women representatives work under the close supervision of their male guardians and they do not take decisions on their own. However, many women sarpanch have taken bold steps for the betterment of life in the villages. In some cases, they have received support from their family members too. More participation of women in the panchayats means that the funds are usually used properly. Issues such as sanitation, education of girls, domestic violence, alcohol, de-addiction have gained importance. In 1993, one of the most important steps for the empowerment of women was taken by reserving 33% seats for women in panchayats. This led to the election of ground 1 million women at the village, block and district levels. In a landmark decision in August 2009, the central government approved 50% reservation for the women in panchayats across the country. The decisions means that women will not play an even bigger role in the rural local governance.
So I hope the chapter is clear to everybody. Still you feel if you have any doubt, any query, just read the chapter thoroughly and underline the difficult words and lines. Okay, till our next video.